The Frank Haith Show, brought to you by Don Thornton Cadillac, Pepsi, River Spirit, TTCU, The Credit Union, Bill Knight Ford, and St. Francis Health System. And now your host, Bruce Howard.
Hello again, everybody, and welcome to the Frank Haith Show. I'm Bruce Howard, joined by the basketball coach at the University of Tulsa, Frank Haith, and we've got some catching up to do. The month of November, six games, coach, and as you get ready, first of all, talk about the excitement you had this year with all the new players getting ready for this 2016-2017 season.
Well, it's been a fun go at it so far. You know, we got a whole new team, 10 new players. We've had some good moments. We've had some not so good moments, but all in all, I like where this team is at. I think we're heading in the right direction. We're taking baby steps, but we're getting there.
Well, and with the record at 3-3, as you mentioned, you said it had some good and not so good, but certainly the showing some flashes and showing, certainly at this point, showing some improvement, aren't they?
Absolutely. You know, we got off to a tough start because our first couple games, we didn't have all our players. And then, you know, Jaleel missed the first two games. Corey didn't know he was going to play in the first game until right a couple hours before the tip. So, after that first two games, I thought we made some progress, and we're seeing steady improvement for sure.
Well, after six games, TU at 3-3, but in the midst of all of that was a very nice three-game winning streak, which, of course, we'll be highlighting, and this is the WTWB show, which means wall-to-wall ball. We have nothing but highlights coming your way as we catch you up on TU basketball. Back with more in a moment on the Frank Haith Show.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for seven straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a seven-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds, the kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power. University of Tulsa, a top 50 private institution.
We're back on the Frank Haith Show. And coaches, you started the season, it was Jacksonville State. And again, you're still kind of winding your way through this team. What about that Jacksonville State game?
Well, we did see Junior E2's first game here at TU get a double-double, 20-10. But we didn't play great, you know, and Jacksonville State's a veteran team, and they played very well in here our first time.
Yeah, they really shot the ball well as we take a look at some of the numbers as the Hurricane falling in game number one. And you trailed by quite a bit in the second half, but you made a run in the second half.
Made a run. Corey Henderson made some shots there late, which was good to see.
All right, now the next game for the Hurricane was at Wichita State, and you knew that the Shockers would be loaded because of the way that you handled them here last year. You knew they'd be ready.
Yeah, and their front line is very good, and they play extremely well. We did a good job on their guards. But I felt good coming out of that game because I thought we learned something.
Well, and Pat Burt certainly did a nice job on the road, hit some threes, kind of got it unlocked. And as you can see, Pat ended up with 17 points and four assists. Pat's doing a better job dishing the ball, too.
I think he's leading our team in assists right now, and we want to keep that going, and along with getting his scoring up, too.
And you look at that score, and it's a little misleading because certainly there were some times in the game when you were right in there, and then Wichita State had a couple of huge runs. All right, let's take a look at highlights now of a home match against New Orleans. And this is a match, you know, you're starting to think about a little bit of pressure and trying to get things done, and you did it.
It's our first game with Jahlil back, and, you know, New Orleans is a veteran team, too. I mean, they had all seniors, and later on in the year, they've beaten Washington State, and they've had some really good wins. So they're a very talented team, and I thought our guys, obviously Jahlil right there, came in this ball game ready to play.
Yeah, they were ahead 8-0, and then Jahlil's basket made it 8-3. And this guy right here, TK Adoge, had a monster game.
He did. He looked, obviously at career highs, rebounding and scoring in that ball game. And they're sharing the ball. You know, Junior hitting Pat Burt in the corner there, just good shot, great shot.
13-10 is your score at that point with New Orleans still in the lead. And now here later on, wow, what a play by Jahlil Wheeler on the dunk, and we'll get another look at it.
Well, and Jahlil is a very good athlete. And obviously, we also see what we've missed the first two games, not having him in the lineup and our leading scorer.
Yeah, he ended up getting that dunk and making it an 8-point game. Still behind here in the first half. And Gino Artisan, you're going to see a lot of this from him, I'm sure.
Yeah, you know, guy with size, that can shoot the ball, he's got a nice touch. And I think he's really getting better and better each day.
Well, in the Hurricane at that point down 23-18. But right here, TK Adoge with that dunk making it 27-26. So now you're right back there.
Yeah, nice lip action in our one game, and good pass, good finish.
And another nice drive, nice penetration by the Hurricane, but guess who's there to clean it up?
As Martin Zimbano, another freshman, is coming along nicely here early in the year.
Igbanu made it 32-30 at that point, still trailing. And again, Martins will make a play here, and that makes it a 2-point game. But at halftime, you're tied at 34-34.
Yeah, on that play, there was a great pass by Junior, which was good to see us sharing the basketball.
So you go to the second half after the game is tied at 34-34. A lot of the numbers quite even, although I'm sure you'd like to see your free throw percentage to be just a bit higher, huh?
Yeah, and I think we're going to be a good free throw shooting team. So it started out in the second half. I thought we did a really good job of getting that ball inside, which is what we need to get that paint touches. I think our post guys are really important to our success this year.
Again, E2 with the assist on that one, and here comes Junior E2 after a steal.
Nice finish and transition by the big fellow.
Tulsa ahead at that point, 42-38, and you start to extend the lead against this New Orleans team. Good pass inside, or good penetration.
Good penetration, nice pick up there by TK and finish.
Sterling Taplin with that penetration for the Golden Hurricane.
Heck of a play right here by TK, just an unbelievable hustle play, staying after the ball. And then drive it in there and finish it. How many times that ball, he looks like he's going to lose it. And just great passion and desire right there.
Yeah, he kept a lot of balls alive, didn't he?
And quick jumping, you know, getting off the floor, you know. And again, nice catch by Will. And I think Will's another one of our bigs. Just continue to get better and better each day.
Taplin with the assist. That's a 12-point lead for you now at 54-42.
Again, nice pass by Junior. Good finish by Will. Junior's the kind of player with that size. He can shoot it, he can deck it, and do a lot of different things.
Well, certainly a nice win for you, especially considering, as you mentioned, obviously, that New Orleans has had a couple of good wins since then. So you outscore them by 9 in the second half and win it by 9. Good win.
Real good win. You know, we're going to play a lot of these teams that they look like they're lower level, but they got seniors, senior-laden team. They're a tough matchup, and I thought our guys handled themselves well. Knowing we had not won yet, so we hadn't got all our confidence right yet. But we really found a way to come out of here and play well, play hard, get ourselves a W.
So Tulsa wins the game to get to 1-2. It would be the start of a 3-game winning streak. And we'll talk about another couple of wins for Tulsa coming up on The Frank Haith Show.
I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds, the kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power. University of Tulsa, a top 50 private institution.
Welcome back to the Frank Haith Show. And Coach, you hosted Oregon State here at the Reynolds Center, and it's kind of like the start of the revenge tour. All of these teams, a few of them who beat you last year, including Oregon State, you knew that's a good program coming in.
Yes, and they had an outstanding year, an NCAA tournament team, a lot of good players coming back, you know, Tinkle, the kid Eubanks, and I thought we were really focused early in this ball game. We talked about, we call those pump fakes in the paint against their bigs, and Martin's get off to a really good start, shot faking and finishing inside.
And unlike the New Orleans game, you get off to a really nice start.
Yeah, we did. And, you know, it's all about our execution and getting defensive stops. And, you know, just you saw Jaleel right there, a nice mid-range jump shot. Pat hits a step-in three. You know, we really, you know, 10-2 to start this ball game was a really, really good start for us.
So the Hurricane up 10-2, and they would continue to play well and increase that lead. And Sterling Taplin gets open for a three and knocks it in, 16-5.
Yeah, just great passing. You know, Lawson with the skip pass, then Pat with the extra pass to Sterling, you know.
Speaking of Lawson Carita, here is his first three-pointer of the ball game, and he knocks that one home. You're up by 9.
Good inside-out play, he and Will. You know, just, you know, continue to share the ball.
Now, here's something that Junior E2 can do that maybe some people don't know about. He can make that three-pointer, can he? He can step outside.
He can. I think he's shooting, up over 40% from three, and he's got a nice touch. He's worked hard on it. That was the one thing he really worked hard on his sit-out year.
7-point lead, and then Jaleel Wheeler does what Jaleel Wheeler does, which is just get inside, get tough, create contact, and make the play. Outstanding.
Yeah, just a great finish, you know. Attacking closeouts right there. And taking right at the big 6'11 kid and finishing through in traffic, which is a big-time play.
And already folks are really falling in love with Jaleel Wheeler and the way he plays for the Hurricane. And at that point, TU starts to get their lead back up to double digits.
Again, nice assist there. McCorey just and Jaleel's got good range on his three, too. So he's a guy that can also drive it, but also can make a catch and shoot three. Again, that's Corey Henderson, another guy that can shoot the ball, too. So we got a number of guys that can have big nights and shoot the ball. And you see us there at the half. We're up 37-22, shooting the ball well, but also defending well.
Yeah, and a 41% three-point percentage rate, which is very good. And you had the double-digit lead. But you knew Oregon State would come back, and they would make a run in the second half. And here they go. Early in the second half, they get it going.
Yeah, Power 5 team, you know, team from the NCAA tournament last year. You know they were going to make a run. And yeah, they executed very well here beginning of the second half and went right at us and, you know, took it right to us off the bounce. Nice finish right there with Eubanks. We were very fearful of him. He's a very good player. But I give our guys credit. They cut it all the way down to 2 or 1, I think, here. It cuts it to 1. And I don't think we ever relinquished the lead in this ball game.
No, Kendall Manuel with that jump shot making it a 40-39 game, but then your team finds its legs, if you will.
Yeah, really good execution out of bounds play, flashing right there, and obviously a great finish by Jaleel.
So the Hurricane now upping their lead to 3 after that special play, and again, he's tough inside. It's not easy to go inside amongst the trees and make plays.
No, and he's just got that toughness about him to finish through traffic. Good execution right here. And obviously Junior stepping up, making another three.
So Junior E2 knocks that one home, and Tulsa's gotten the lead back up to 8 at that point, 47-39.
Yeah, we needed to just defend right here. And there's Sterling running through in the passing lane. I thought he had a really good floor game this ball game too. I think he had like 10 points, a couple assists, no turnovers, maybe one turnover, but had a really good floor game.
Tulsa's lead back up to 9 at that point, and it's 9 here, and now make it 11 on the dunk by TK. Great pass.
Yeah, great pass by Pat. Good pick and roll pass by Pat, and obviously great finish by TK.
Oregon State still trying to keep it close, but every time your team had an answer.
Yeah, great movement by Junior on a drive, and nice find by Sterling on that pass.
So back up by 11 at that point, and the Golden Hurricane going on to the win at 75-64. Really satisfying win over a power five school, if you will.
Yeah, and Tinkle got hurt after our ball game, and once they get him back, they'll do well in their conference, I really believe. But I was very encouraged by the last couple ball games and how our guys have grown since Jacksonville State.
So you get a couple of victories at home, and that kind of does get your legs a little bit. Now you're ready to maybe go on the road and win, or it looks like at this point the team's starting to gel a little bit, right?
Yeah, and we had another true road game coming up right after that game, feeding off our first true road game against Wichita State. So we had to get ourselves going.
Yeah, ORU is the next game, and we'll have highlights of that coming up next on The Frank Haith Show.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds, the kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power. University of Tulsa, a top 50 private institution.
Welcome back to the Frank Haith Show. And Coach, you get ready for ORU and the crosstown rivalry. What was the approach going in? Because they won 3 in a row.
Yeah, and basically we just wanted, this next game. We really did try to tell our guys about, hey, let's build on the momentum. We've won 2 in a row, and this is our next true road game. After Wichita State, we want to have a better performance than we did against Wichita State. And we know how important this game is.
Well, and ORU got off to the good start as Chris Martin knocked down that shot. And then moments later, the young man inside, Albert Owens, makes it 8-2. But your team didn't panic.
No, and Owens is a load in there. He's a really good player. He's really developed, and they go to him. But I thought we got ourselves going here. Nice pass there by Sterling. Good finish by TK. Once we got going, got some rhythm, we were fine there at the end of the beginning of the first half.
Corey Henderson got it going. That's a sparkling play by Henderson.
Yeah, nice ball ahead by Corey Haight there, and a good finish.
So the Hurricane down at 14-9, and again, Wheeler just like his teammate Jaleel, Henderson, just like his teammate Wheeler, knowing how to finish inside.
Yes, yes, and using that rim to get a nice give and go cut finish here by Jaleel, but great pass by Will, you know, splashing up there, and we've seen that before with Shaquille Harris and some other bigs last year.
Jaleel Wheeler, of course, with that basket, making it a one-point lead. And there you get one of your first leads of the game, 26-23, and it's Pat Burton knocking one in.
Yeah, and it's good to see Pat see that ball go through the hoop a little bit. And then all of a sudden, you know, open up for a bunch of our guys. Henderson with a nice three in transition, give us a three-point lead there.
31-28 at that point. Good defense by TU after the slow start. Really thought you did nice interior-wise, and Will Magne was a part of that, wasn't he?
He really was. I mean, he's a rim protector, and he's done a nice job of that. And good transition bucket there by Travis Atson, another newcomer.
And it was good to see Travis get really aggressive on that situation and have a chance to score, and he put it in. And there you see the halftime numbers as the Golden Hurricane is ahead in the ballgame at halftime, but certainly this one not out of the woods yet, is it?
No, a rivalry game. And you know they were going to come out and play in the second half on their court and, you know, went back and forth there for the most part about the first 5-6 minutes of the second half. Nice pass, nice shot by Jaleel.
Yeah, that gives you a 42-38 lead as they had knocked it down to one.
Again, nice pass and transition. Good finish, good rebound here by Martins and good finish.
Igbanu making it 47-42, and you start to pull away. But then ORU goes on a little bit of a run here. This will be their high water mark as Jalen Bradley knocks down a three. You're down 53-50.
Yeah, and I think once that's 53-50, I think we went on a 16-0 run right after this and really got a separation here. Good execution and nice pass and obviously really good finish by Will there on that tie low up.
Junior E2 with the assist for the Golden Hurricane. We'll get a good look at it. And again, we're seeing quite a few nice passes high-low by Junior.
Yeah, we this is our one game in which when the team's hard hedges on ball screens, we run it, and our bigs got to be good passers in it.
That kind of sparks things for the Hurricane. And again, Travis Atson, a little bit of his coming out party, if you will, as he had 10 points and 5 rebounds for you.
Yeah, really nice play point out by Corey Henderson. And playing off 2 feet, not going out of control, staying under control, make that pass.
And the run continues for TU. You can see that the Hurricane up 64-53, and that's a tough shot, and Corey put it in, Corey Henderson, and there you have the 16-0 run.
Yeah, a good sweep drive there, attacking their defense, and great finish. And then we really worked the game here to finish the game out, attacking them off the bounce.
I was going to say, you guys were relentless getting to the rim, weren't you?
Yeah, we didn't settle, and that's what teams do when you're trying to win ball games. Don't settle, taking a good shot, and we shot the ball well from the free throw line, so it was a really good win for us.
Yep, 45% for the ball game, and you see Wheeler with 15 and Pat Burt with 12. But really, as you see the 14-point victory, a contribution by almost everybody on your team, and you use depth certainly as well, right?
Yeah, we played 12 guys, and everybody that played contributed. It was a really good win. I thought our guys showed some poise, some composure on the road. We had some nice TU folks come over, too, mm-hmm. So it was good to see our folks in the building, but it was really, really good win for us.
Well, good to get the cup back, and it just shows the growth and the progression of the team as a 3-game winning streak now. Had to feel pretty good about the way your team has evolved to that point, right?
Yes. You know, obviously we were getting better and better, and I think this team, you go back to Jacksonville State to where we're at after ORU, we made drastic improvements. Now we just can't settle. We got to keep it going.
So the Golden Hurricane with the win over ORU, and they would have another road game before getting back home. And we'll talk about that game. And in fact, we'll talk about that game right now because it is the Little Rock game. And Coach, you go on the road again to Little Rock, and unfortunately Little Rock came up with a victory, but you had some positive things. Will Magne was one of them.
And he was. He played outstanding, protected the rim, saved us on a lot of buckets, and he had a good offensive game.
And there's your final score. Little Rock with a run of their own late in the first half, which erased what was an 8-point lead for the Golden Hurricane. And Little Rock winning by a final score of 72-62. Certainly a disappointing loss, but Little Rock's obviously a pretty good team. Tournament team a year ago, right?
5 seniors, veteran team, and they'll do well in their conference.
Well, so TU now 3-3 on the season, and we get ready for further action as the Golden Hurricane will be back home this week, and we'll be talking about that when we continue on the Frank Haith Show in a moment.
Top 10.
I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds. The kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power. University of Tulsa, a top 50 private institution.
We're back on the Frank Haith Show as the Golden Hurricane. A busy week, but it's a busy week at home, and it starts Wednesday against Illinois State, a former Missouri Valley Conference rival.
Yeah, tremendous week for us. Illinois State's outstanding basketball team, and I've watching them on tape. They got a great point guard. They got they're very athletic, well-coached, but a tremendous opportunity for us. And then you look at Saturday, play Oklahoma State team, who's done very, very well. They got another great point guard in Evans, who will be a challenge for us, and they're playing a different style up and down. But a tremendous week for TU Nation to come in here and see us play two really good ball clubs.
And absolutely, you'll know that OSU will be loaded for bear because they remember Tulsa going to Stillwater and winning the game last year. They'll be ready, won't they?
They will be. And like I said, Brad Underwood's taken over there, the former head coach of Stephen F. Austin, outstanding coach, and they'll be ready to play.
All right, so we're done with wall-to-wall ball on the Frank Haith Show. As we've got you caught up, next week we'll review those two games we just mentioned on the Frank Haith Show. Thanks, Coach. Good start.
Thank you, Bruce.
We'll be back next week. So long, everybody.
The Frank Haith Show, brought to you by Don Thornton Cadillac, Pepsi, River Spirit, TTCU, The Credit Union, Bill Knight Ford, and St. Francis Health System. The Frank Haith Show has been a presentation of Golden Hurricane Sports Properties and a Kane Vision production.